What's up everyone, welcome back to the channel, and this is an updated video on my Ace Combat 6 on PC tutorial. With the recent Xenia updates, the soundtrack issue has been fixed. The music doesn't overlap anymore during missions with the new decoder, but the cutscenes audio, however, are still messed up. So even if you didn't watch my previous video, this one will cover everything so you can start playing this game now. So let's get going. If you're planning on buying on Amazon, please use my affiliate link below in the description. Any product on the website will count and you will be directly supporting the channel. So the first thing we're gonna get is the emulator itself through the Xenia Manager software. The link of this page will be on the description of this video. And in here, you're gonna click on whatever it is the latest release currently available. At the moment that I'm recording this, it's version 50.2, but regardless of what you have here, you're gonna click on that and scroll to the bottom where it says Assets, and you're gonna click on xeniamanager.zip to download this manager. So download this one to your PC. So this file will be on the zip format, meaning that you're gonna have to extract this, and you can use either WinRAR or 7-zip for that. I'm gonna personally recommend you to use 7-zip. I'll put the link of that on the description of the video. So download and install that. So in my case, I created this folder called Xenia Manager, and there are two things you can do here. First, you right-click the file, select 7-zip or WinRAR depending on what you have, and if you click on Extract here, the files will be on this folder. But if you didn't create a folder and just downloaded the zip file, you're gonna click on Extract to Xenia Manager. That way, they're all gonna be inside a folder. But in my case, I'm gonna click here on Extract here. Then you're gonna have these two files with you. At this point, you can go ahead and delete the original zip file. We're not gonna need this anymore. And to start this, you're gonna double click on this Xenia Manager application. When you do that, this window will pop up and it will generate these files, and then you're gonna see this one here. So on this window, you're gonna click on Install Xenia Canary. This is the build with the latest updates that we're gonna need for this game. So once that's installed, click on OK. And now, this same Xenia Manager folder is also where I'm gonna be dropping the ISO of Ace Combat 6. This disk image file right here, and you're gonna have to find this game file on your own. And once you have that in place, you're gonna go back to the manager, click on this Add Game button, and it should open the same Xenia Manager folder. So now you just have to double click on Ace Combat 6 ISO. It will open the emulator and then close to extract the information. Now on this window, you're just gonna click on the Ace Combat 6 game name right here. Gonna take a few seconds and then the game will pop up right here. So now we're gonna tweak the Xenia settings for this game. And for that, you're gonna click on the Xenia settings button right here, and it's gonna open this window. Right here, the first thing you're gonna do is click on Xenia Canary Profile and then select the game, Ace Combat 6, that is. After that, you're gonna click on this button, Open in Editor, because there's a setting we have to change that is only available through here. So now there's a bunch of settings here, but there's only one thing we have to change. So the first thing you're gonna do is on this notepad, you're gonna press Ctrl F on your keyboard to bring up the Find window. And on this box where it says Find What, you're gonna click here and type AC6 and then click on Find Next. And just like that, it will find this section of the notepad, the hex with the ground fix for Ace Combat 6. So right here, all you have to do is erase the false and replace this with true. So that is enabled. That's all you gotta do here for Ace Combat 6. Now, don't forget to save this. Click on File on top and then click on Save, or you can press Ctrl S on your keyboard. And that's all we have to do here on the notepad. Now, back on the Xenia Manager, here on Audio Settings, the first thing you're gonna change is Max Queued Frames. Click on this number 8, erase this, and type 16. This is gonna fix a possible audio delay that this emulator has. Now, still here on audio settings, we're gonna change these two settings right here. On dedicated XMA thread, click on on to turn this off. and on the bottom, audio decoder, click on this one and set to on. This will fix the soundtrack issue of this game. Now scrolling down a bit more here on display settings, on vertical sync, you're gonna click here to set this off. Now on frame limit, there are two things you can do here. If you want to play the game at the original 30 FPS, you're gonna change the frame limit here to 60 FPS. That is because when you set this to 60 FPS, the menus, the briefing screen, and the aircraft selection screen are gonna be played at 60 FPS. But when it gets to actual gameplay, it will change to 30 FPS. So if you want to play the game at 60 FPS, then you have to change this to 120 FPS. That way, the menus, the briefing, and the aircraft selection are all gonna be played at 120, and they're gonna be speed up. But when it gets to actual gameplay, then it will run at 60 FPS, in which you can play the game just fine if your PC can support that. And also on NVIDIA driver settings, if you do have a NVIDIA GPU, you need to match the same frame rate that you set it here, because this option will override the other one or the other way around. I'm not really sure here, but just keep the values the same for both settings here and you are good to go. Now scroll down a bit more to arrive at graphical settings, and on graphics API, you're gonna click this and change to D3D12. This game doesn't render properly at Vulkan API, so you have to select this one right here, in which the game plays just fine too. Now on render target path, click on this one and set to RTV, because if you set this to auto, sometimes the game will boot on the ROV path, in which the performance will be much, much worse. And that's all of the settings you have to change here. Do not use the draw resolution scale, because if you increase this one, the game is going to look pixelated. So you have to play at the original resolution here, but you can mess around with anti-aliasing and play this with FXAA, and also the scaling and sharpening as well, if you want a better image output. But that's gonna be up to you here. And there we go. These are the settings for Ace Combat 6. Now plug in your controller, that is your Xbox controller, because this emulator still only supports X input API, but you can use a PlayStation controller like DualShock 4 and DualSense, but you're gonna have to use programs that emulate the X input format like DS4 Windows and DualSense X. I'll put the link of those on the description of the video. Now for installing DLC, the first thing I'm gonna do is drop the DLC files that I have here with me on the Xenia Manager folder. I have three pieces of DLC for this game, and just like the game, you're gonna have to find the DLC on your own. And once you have them in place, to install that, you're gonna right-click the game icon, select Content, and then click on Install DLC Updates. Now this window will open, and you're gonna click on the icon on the bottom and navigate to the location where your DLC is. Since I have three pieces of DLC, I'm just gonna select everything at once, press and hold the left button on your mouse to select everything, and then click on Open. And then the DLC will show up in here, and all you gotta do is click on Confirm, wait a few seconds, and there you go. Now the DLC is in place. And now to start the game, you just have to click on the icon right here. The emulator will start, and to go full screen, you need to press F11 on your keyboard. Don't worry about these datas right here. This is something that I activated from outside. It's not going to look like that for you. Also, when you start this for the first time, to save your progress, you need to create a gamer profile. And if you just click on this button right here, it's gonna open up this window. And in here, all you gotta do is select Create Profile, and then just type in whatever name or tag you want to use, and then click on Create. Now click on the second bar and select your profile. It's gonna show up in here, and then just click on OK. And now you can save your progress in game and you can start playing this. I have many emulation guide videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff, subscribe to the channel, and also leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.